2013, we published a clinical practice guideline that was evidence-based on congenital muscular torticollis. But the literature is very strong that just publication of a guideline alone doesn't mean that it'll be implemented. So a year and a half later, we did a survey of physical therapists to see whether or not they had actually read the guideline and implemented the recommendations that we made.
What did you find?
Well, we asked therapists to identify what they were doing prior to the publication of the guideline and afterwards. And we found that 90% of the clinicians prior to the publication of the guideline were doing most of what we had recommended in examination and in treatment. But after the guideline, all of those areas actually did increase a little bit. So by the end of post-guideline production, they reported 99% were adhering to at least 4 of the 5 intervention recommendations, and greater than 90% overall were doing all of the examination recommendations.
Coming out of this then, what are your recommendations for clinicians?
The areas of examination and intervention, while they saw a leap, were not the areas of the greatest change. The greatest change came in actually classifying the children by severity. Prior to the guideline, there really weren't any agreed upon classification tools or scales. And now, we, as part of the guideline, we created one that we felt would merge the prognostic variables that were in the literature. Clinicians have taken to that classification system quite well. They've actually used it to influence prognosis in discussions with parents. So the two areas that jumped the highest were classification of severity and actually making a prognosis about the episode of care for an individual infant.
You have done this in congenital muscular torticollis, but it's actually a case that can be applied then to introducing guidelines in other aspects of care. What do you think are the big lessons coming out of your exercise?
Well, I think that what we've learned from the knowledge brokering questions are that clinicians need tools to implement the recommendations. So it's not enough just to publish the recommendations, but the two areas that they ask for the most was a parent-friendly brochure and a documentation template. So they could take what the recommendations were and immediately move that into practice. We've actually moved on both of those recommendations, and there's a template now available in publication in 2016, and there's a knowledge translation committee in our knowledge translation task force that they are developing the brochure.